Psychologists use the term off-track behavior to describe the action this story talks about. Watch the two women. Both are reading, still reading, then one, then the other looks away. You might describe what's happening by another term, mind wandering, or even daydreaming.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything inherently good or bad about daydreaming or mind wandering. It depends on the context.
Psychology professor Dr. Michael Kane has thought a lot about mind wandering. His research finds, on average, we spend about one-third of our time being off task or daydreaming.
So there are clearly some contexts in which it's really important to think about what you're doing, because when you don't, you tend to make mistakes. But, you know, there's a lot of what we do in daily life where we don't have to concentrate.
One of the primary experiments that tested for mind wandering involved digital devices. They gave the students the devices, in this case, these Palm Pilots. They were asked to carry them around all day, and when the device beeped, they were asked to keep track of what they were doing. Were they on task? Were they daydreaming? What was I saying? Three studies using students at the University of North Carolina at Greensboro found that while the average amount of time spent off task or mind wandering was 30%, the actual amount of time varied widely. It also depended on the individual. Some people reported almost never being off task, while others were off task almost 90% of the time. The amount of time people spent off task also depended on what exactly they were doing.
This activity has special meaning to me. Sure, of course it does. I choose this activity.
Not at all.
Not at all.
Right.
Now, this is asking about what kind of music someone is listening to at the time, with a number of different choices. So,
researchers asked participants to explain what they were doing and how they felt about what they were doing when they were off task.
So if people are doing things that are boring, if they say they'd prefer to be doing something else at the time, if they're anxious, if they're finding their activity stressful, they're more likely to be thinking about something else. But if they are happy, if they report trying to concentrate on what they were doing, if they are doing something that they're good at, they tend to be more focused on the task.
In general, the study determined people mind wander or daydream whenever they are bored with what they are doing. It also found many times people don't realize they are daydreaming. Routine tasks are simply accomplished. And that begs the question, can mind wandering be controlled? Could a person really concentrate on one thing long enough and force themselves not to daydream?
We call the assessments of mind wandering, we call them thought probes. They're probing people's thoughts. A screen will come up and ask the person to tell us what they were thinking about in the moment right before the screen came.
To find out, subjects were brought into the lab and asked to complete specific tasks. The study found while concentration helped a person to stay on task, the amount of time people spent mind wandering is pretty stable.
The people who mind wander a lot out in their lives also are the ones who tend on average to mind wander a lot in the lab tasks that we give them. So there is something pretty stable about people's propensity to mind wander. It's not a perfect correlation, right? There's a lot that goes into whether or not someone is mind wandering in the moment. But on average, people who mind wander out in daily life mind wander in one lab task, they also mind wander in another lab task and in another.
So why do people go off task or mind wander? If daydreaming is such a significant part of our lives, it must be valuable for something. But so far, there is little evidence it helps with creativity. Mind wandering is a way to rest the brain.
The easiest kind of perspective to latch onto is just to kind of get out of your current moment. So if we were sitting in traffic, if we had to exist in every moment in traffic on our drive home from work, we might go crazy. So it could be just as simple as that, and not have any larger purpose.
You know, there's a lot of what we do in daily life where we don't have to concentrate, where we can rely on habits, well-learned routines. So you can drive home from work thinking about your next meal, arrive home safely in the driveway with no idea how you got there, right? Sometimes you come to when you get home and you think, how did I do that? But you did it. You didn't have to think about what you were doing. In those occasions, when you're doing something fairly well practiced, fairly automatic, why not use this additional cognitive capability you have to escape the here and now and do some mental work on other projects you may have, right? So you may have a personal problem you want to work through. You may have a challenging intellectual problem. And so what's a really nice feature of the human mind is that we can work on those things, even though they're not right in front of us at the moment.